Hello friends and my dear students, as we are studying industrial engineering method study, we have covered that how you can start and recognize the symbols of the process chart in the previous session. So today we will, in line with that particular topic of the process chart, we will see that how you can prepare and what are the initial draft of that. Okay, myself Shubham Awasthi and I am working as assistant professor in the mechanical engineering department at Government Engineering College, Banswara. So in the previous session, we have seen that what are the various symbols used in the preparation of the charts, what do these symbols denote, or how you can distinguish among those. And today we will see the factors to be considered in the construction of the chart and the operation process chart and its objective and goal, and what is the application of that operation process chart. So these are the few objectives of this particular session we will see, and the students will be able to understand at the end of the session. Okay, now these are the summary of the symbols along with their results. What are the activities and which symbols should be used? Like for the operation, that circle should be used, and the predominant result of this operation is it produces, means accomplishes the work by changing the shape, change of material or document, furthers the process. These are the results where you can utilize this particular operation. Then inspection means recognize, check for the quality, checking the accuracy or appearance, checking correctness of data on a document, checking the quantity by physical counts of bait, or any other measure where you are just checking some, doing some kind of inspection or quality check. So where the places you can use this particular square symbol for the inspection. Okay, next is the transportation activity, means for the travel movement of worker, material or equipment, or any document from one place to other which should be significant to be measured. So that should be represented by this arrow of transportation. The last is delay, means you have to be represented by D, means any uncontrolled storage or delay, means some temporary storage if you are showcasing or representing that activity of the process or job. So that delay between the consecutive operations or interference, that should be depicted by delay or small d. This is basically for the temporary storage. The last one is storage, means controlled storage, that was uncontrolled storage. Controlled storage is where material, document, items are retained, holds, kept or retains. So that kind of operations or that kind of result, if you are getting it with the help of storage symbol or storage activity. So this is all about the five symbols which we have seen. Clear? So an operation come transportation, then you can use this particular symbol, means arrow inside a circle. Inspection come operation, then you can use circle inside square. So these are the combinations of these symbols which can also be used if you are having such activities in which two activities are combining, like operation and transportation are combining, then you can use this symbol, arrow inside a circle. If it is operation combining with the inspection, then you can use circle inside a square. So in such a way you can start utilizing the combination of these symbols of the process chart. Now the construction of the chart, which is a major concern if you are preparing or doing method study. So construction of the chart needs a suitable performer or a standard set of format design on which methods can be charted with the help of following operations. Okay, so that you can figure it out. So types of the charts, like existing name of the chart at the top. Okay, existing or proposed method indicate whether the present study is concerned with the existing method or proposed method. Activity, broad outline of that activity should be mentioned. So these are the things which you have to mention. Then beginning of the activity and end of the activity, means indicate both boundaries of the activity undertaking for the study. An analyst should concentrate within these limits. That should be whatever the analyst who are performing that method study, that should see that activity very deadline, means start and end point of that activity should be considered properly. Name of the recorder, indicate the name who collect the information to prepare that chart, that should be indicated. Then date and time, indicate the clearly and correctly the date and time of that particular activity or job. Summary means indicate the number of different symbols used in the study. Then final action taken, mention the recommendation in a precise manner. That should not be a kind of essay kind of thing, that should be precisely quoted at the end so that everybody can see the chart and say that these are the recommendation has been done. Now this is a sample pro forma, that name, indicate the name of the chart, existing or proposed method you have to mention. Chart begins and chart ends. Chart prepared by date and time. Seat location and diagram number, activity and chart number. Analyst must use the space to describe an activity and method in terms of the symbol, these space. And after that, what you can summary, in the summary, what you can do? Symbols you can use like this, present and proposed, okay? So in this way, and if it is any recommendation, you can write it down at the side. So in this way, you can prepare this particular chart, okay? So tips for the construction of the chart. The chart should be constructed extremely neat and in ink. Initially construct a trial chart by freehand scale, means with the help of pencil you can just prepare, then you start preparing it by your pen, okay? It is better to start from the end of main operation sequence and work backward towards the beginning, means start at the end and come to the start point of that operation, so that you can finalize the activity or process chart in a very nice manner, okay? Operation process chart that we will see. So these are the few tips for preparation of the chart. So you can start in trying to prepare some jobs of process charts. We'll come up with the next session where we will see that what are the objective and advantages of preparing the operation process chart. So till that time, stay tuned with Engineering College Banswara YouTube channel for more such updates about different branches of engineering like mechanical, electrical, civil and computer science engineering. If you have not subscribed to the Engineering College Banswara YouTube channel, do subscribe. And if you like this content, just hit the like button for more such updates about industrial engineering. We'll come up with the next session very soon. Thank you so much for your patience hearing.